I remember like my first day of middle school coming in and being like, I have to prove to people that I'm smart. Like that just has to happen. At first, since I came from a different country, they just kind of thought I didn't know what I was doing. People didn't even like bother to ask like, oh, is this too easy for you? Do you want to do something else? But it was just hard to know that I was different somehow when I felt the same. My favorite parts of school was like science experiments and getting a problem and then finding out a solution from it. And that's when I kind of realized that I had like a more logistical way of thinking and that this is something I enjoy. Like math and science can be taken into my career in like a deeper way. My parents both had degrees and were very highly successful people. And when they came here, they kind of lost all of that and had to start over. So seeing them go through that and coming from such a like a high success maintained lifestyle to basically having nothing and having to start degrees over again was really tough.
We used to tell her that no sacrifice is too much for us to make, especially for them, because 80% of why we are in America is because of them. So we are ready to sacrifice everything for them to really achieve their full potential.
Because they did that, it makes me even want to work so much harder to make sure what they did is validated. Having an opportunity like Abbott in high school is definitely a blessing that I couldn't have asked more for. It kind of puts me ahead of the game, and for me to kind of feel reassured that I do know what I'm doing and just really get what it feels like to be an engineer. I think so many times I see so many girls of color try to put themselves down because they were constantly told, I can't do this, I'm not good enough, I'm not smart enough. So then they put themselves down because of that. And for me to say that I am good enough, I can do this, and tell them that, lifts them up too.